People feel a loss in their life when they're disconnected from nature, when they'd rather watch it on television. In the city, it's just totally closes off nature. Sure, there's little pockets of gardens here and there. But this disconnection from nature makes us unhappy with ourselves. We feel unwhole, empty. And the city is a distraction from that because we can be totally distracted all the time with the many different things that the city has to offer. We've lost that, so we become consumers to try to fill in that missing connection. We're hypnotized. We're taught, get in debt. It's ingrained in us so we can be slaves. Consider that. Who's making the decisions? There's people waking up right now to becoming more free. Instead of being controlled and manipulated, they're starting to wake up and realize that there's an alternative. The first reality of coming to an awakening is seeing everything for what it really is, and it's not very pretty at first. Enlightenment is not for the weak of heart. Enlightenment is for the warrior. I can see infinity in the city, but nothing's permanent. Nothing's permanent. When I first came to the realization of my potential, all these synchronicities started occurring in my life. Beautiful mystical experiences, and they appeared to me to be supernatural. I was awestruck. And then I realized that really my ego was trying to make it into something special so that I would not come to a realization of what was truly happening to me. But right now, the supernatural appears natural. It's just ordinary. The real supernatural experience is being human and being artists, kind of like co-creators of the earth. The point in time where enough people collectively are setting their intentions or embracing this potential. May all beings know happiness. May all beings know happiness.